for Drury. Get you their starting five. Number zero, first, Tyrion Moore, 5'8", fifth-year senior from Kansas City. Kelly Domitz, a 5'5", fifth-year senior, Preston, Missouri. Paige Robinson, who we talked about, 5'10", senior from Bethany, Illinois, went to Oka Valley. Number 32 is Mia Henderson, a 5'11", junior from Overland Park, Kansas. And then number 40, Alana Finley, 5'10", junior from Fairgrove, Missouri. Amy Egan in her second year as head coach of the Lady Panthers. The lights go out for the announcement. The lineups for the home team, the Lewis University Flyers.
This is the first time Drury has come to Romeoville in 6 years. Stephanie Hart, first Flyer, 5'8", senior from Geneva, Illinois.
Taylor Galuza, the 5'8", sophomore from Lincoln Way West. Grace Hilber, the 5'5", junior from Sun Prairie, Wisconsin. Lily Courier, 6-foot sophomore from Lyons Township. And Katherine Schmidt, the 6-foot sophomore from Burlington Central High School. Kat, and our leading scorer coming in, and she has been really on a tear of late. Get 15 points per game right now for Kat, 6 boards a contest. Grace Silber, 14.5 points per contest. Taylor Galuza at 12 a game. Of course, we're without Jenna Badali's 11 a game. The reigning freshman of the year out for the season. But other than Jenna, we are now healthy. And with this set lineup, finally healthy and together, that's why we've reeled off the 5 wins in a row, including, again, against number 18 in the country, UMSL, 2 days ago when the Flyers won by 10. So, again, Flyers will be in the black. It's pink for the Drury Lady Panthers here this evening. Again, Drury hasn't been here in 6 years. We played there earlier in the season, and we were up 9 after 3 quarters. They rallied and got the win. We only had 8 players on the bus for that game, missing 3 starters. They missed Paige Robinson. So both teams pretty healthy here tonight. See what happens in the rematch. Flyers go left to right in front of me as I'm up in the balcony. Tip controlled by the pink. And here we go. So they'll get started. Again, normally you play teams out of your conference once. This year we're playing them twice, which is why it's a home and home. But for whatever reason, every other time in the last 6 years, the one time had been at Drury. High left for 3, up and over the backboard and out of bounds. So, Diamonds will miss that one, and Flyers will get possession. And invariably, it'd be the biggest game of the year, because these two teams, as the inbounds will full court pressure, it's knocked away, and Flyers will try again. It seems like 3 coaches in a row, I would say, talk to Lisa Carlson and say, well, biggest game of the year, good luck on the road. And I said that to Sam, you know, I said that to Kristen. I said, at least it's a home and home finally here. Kat has it high right as they break the press. Go high right side. Hilbert, out of the free throw line, Courier. Side to Schmidt. Shot clock down to 8 for Grace. She'll drive, dish, good feed to Lily, who makes the layup. So Flyers get on the board first. Good execution offensively. Get back on defense. The right side of the free throw line. Pass is knocked away and stolen. Flyers in the middle of the break with Schmidt. She'll go all the way, left side layup, no, but a foul. And she'll go to the stripe and shoot 2. The hustling Panthers get back defensively to corral her, but still Kat to the stripe. And brutal weather conditions. You heard the weather, and Joe, well, before we went on the air and the traffic, there's all sorts of accidents. Free throw good for Kat. It's been snowing since 1:30 here. So it's been snowing really hard for about 4 straight hours, and it's going to continue for a while. That one missed, so 3-0 it is. Here comes Drury. They'll run the floor in a hurry.
for a quick left side three that is no good. It's long. Rebound knocked out of bounds, and they're going to call a foul. I think they are going to call a foul on Drury. Missed there by Robinson. Flyers against the press. Not very often do we get pressed, I can tell you that. We'll do some pressing ourselves, but man, they talk about us breaking presses too often. We'll run the floor there. Well, we break that easily, get a layup for Kat Schmidt. Well, that press break worked about as well as you can work it. And 5-0 Flyers here very early. They do have very good ball handlers, and that's the thing about all five on the floor. They can all shoot threes, and they can all handle the basketball. Shot clock running down to 10 as they drive right side. Bank that one up. No good. Rebound tapped out. Steph Hart has it. Flyers on the run. The release to Hilbert. Layup blocked from behind, but a foul. And now Greece will go to the line to shoot two. So very good aggressive start here for the Flyers. Certainly playing with confidence. And you know, the COVID early in the season was such a disruptor for us. That's why that record, 10 and 12, doesn't really describe how good this team is. It really hit this team hard as Grace hits the first free throw. And as you heard Matt say, we hardly had any five-on-five practices. That free throw good. Literally until this month. I mean, it was just that tough. And then who's eligible, who isn't. Then we had other injuries. And finally, the back and healthy in just about every way and playing like it. Robinson to the free throw line. She'll take the jumper from there and rattle that one in. Well, that's how talented a jump shooter she is. She barely even squared to the basket before she let that one fly. They're on the board, 7-2, but took them 2 minutes, 15 seconds to get on the board. This time, Hart tried to get it to Schmidt, breaking to the basket. Pass from up high, down low, goes over the head of Cat and out of bounds. So pass had too much on it, and Panthers will come the other way. Drury where they are, number 4 in the nation for a reason. This could be a heck of a matchup. The men's game to follow. Robinson from 17, good there. Well, again, we're just going to have somebody in her pocket all day long. She'll just keep doing that all day long. Hard to the free throw line. High right side. Looking for Galuza. They go left to Hilbert. Flip it in the left corner. It's partially deflected. Ball loose, and they'll take it away. So good defense there. The turnover created. Finley gets it into the front. Dometz on the right side gets a bucket and a foul. She'll go to the line. Go to complete the three-point play. So Kat will pick up the whistle there. Mentioned Robinson at 23 points per game. Then Finley at 15 a contest. Dometz comes in at 14 a game. And that one good. Now they really spread it around after that. Carrying Moore at 8 a game. The same for Peyton Richards. 7 a game for Zia Lynch. 2 Flyers in the front, 7 all tie. Panthers come roaring back. And we get it to Courier down the low right side. And banks in a 3-footer. So 9-7 Lewis. Right side, free throw line, Robinson, and she traveled. Yep, nice job. It's always going to be our senior Stephanie Hart who gets the toughest defensive assignment. She was right in Robinson's face there, and Paige trying to plant the foot to take that shot in the paint, skidded, and it goes back over to Lewis. And last time out, they did not have a Tuesday game like we did. They played Saturday. And trounced McHenry 111-55. Kat picks up her dribble, goes right side to Hart. Now Hilber. Hilber to the point. Now free throw line, continues to drive left side, banks it up, no. Rebound battle four, comes out of there. And the Panthers on the run. Come into the front with Finley. Back up top, that's Moore. Way on the right side, number 10, Ellie Clevenger, Harvard freshman. Now Robinson free throw line.
Offense number 23, as Isaiah Lynch, who we just talked about, will steal the pass away. Right side, going all the way for the layup, is good. Grace Hilber. Well, Grace Hilber had an outstanding game two nights ago. She created, what, five steals, I believe. Turnover there. Toss the Panthers. 11-7 Flyers for now. Robinson free throw line. Back up top. They don't take the jumper. Instead, depending on the shot clock, take a 12-footer that will not go, but they get a rebound and start again. It's a new clock after the Clevenger miss. Now Robinson misses a three high left of the yard. And Flyers get that rebound. And Galuza. Well, they double team and knock the ball away. We wanted a foul that didn't come. Robinson, the right side layup. Good. So now they create an offensive possession. We'll break a press and come front in a hurry. A tempo affair here. Galuza left corner. 11-9 Lewis for now. Galuza to Kat. Kat double team in the left block. And they're going to say reach and foul, a little too aggressive on that double team. And we'll bring it in on the basket, but first a media timeout. 4:44 for the first quarter. 11-9 Lewis back in a minute on the Flyers Sports Network. So Drury, number four in the nation, their last loss was to Truman by one. And that was in the middle of January, 67-66. Since then, they really haven't even had a close game. And the closest game you could possibly say that they had was, what, Lindenwood? When they won that 69-58? This should be a close one tonight. Mott's in the game for Lewis, gets the inbound. It off the loser. Side Schmidt. Looks for help. Goes up top. Hilber. Hilber driving right. Pull up jumper from 12 in traffic. No good. Rebound comes down. Panthers. Here they come on offense. That's at the point. The right corner. They close out nicely so they can't take the three. Good defense by Steph there. Baseline left. Take that shot. It's a double team. They knock the ball away temporarily. Shot clock to 8. Clevenger banks it up and in. They stuck with it and got the hoop. And temporarily, Robinson on the bench. Inside Steph. Into the paint. Cat puts up the shot off the glass. No! And the rebound comes down to the Panthers. They'll run the floor in a hurry and miss the layup. Rebound back up, no, and finally, Flyers get it. And has a couple of chances there for Isaiah Lynch, 6 foot, fifth-year senior from Mountain Home, Arkansas. We get down the right side of the lane in a hurry and get the layup. Grace Hilber. Flyers back up two at 13-11. Get off left side. And then, Steph knocked it away from behind and a double team, but they're going to call a reach-in foul there. And Steph will come out. And that means that Tara Galuza, the 5'6 freshman from Lincoln Way West, will come in. So both sisters on the floor at the same time. Baseline left for Drury. They get it in. That's to the free throw line. Slides in, left side layup, no. Rebound comes down to Schmidt. She'll just take it herself, it looks like. Nope, she'll finally find Hilbert, who crosses the timeline and goes right side. A trap up top, so we go down underneath to Mott's. Knocked the ball away from her. She tried to flip it back to Kat Schmidt. Ball knocked out of bounds. Flyers will get it anyway. So 2:46 for the first period, 13-11 Lewis for now. Mention the point standings. For the moment, Humsel still number one, Drury two. Then it's Southern Indiana, Truman, Flyers at 5, followed by Springfield. Kat splits a double team, puts it up with a right hand, a little floating four-footer, good. So Lewis by 4 for now. They have it up top. High right side. Robinson back in the game, has it free throw line. Good bounce pass as they look to double her, and that left Finley open for a layup. If you go by division, Panthers come front. Taylor Galuza, right corner. Hilber for three. Got it. Grace Hilber. Well, three is one of the main reasons why the Flyers were able to knock off Umsel on Tuesday. Get that tray right there and go up five at 18-13. Umsel leads the Central 15-2. Truman's 12-4. Robinson picks up her dribble, just turns, fires, it rolls off the iron, rebound comes down. And that's Tara Galuza to find Motz into the front. Amelia driving all the way to the bucket, lays it up, yes, and a foul, chance for a three-point play. So a good aggressive move for Motz. In the East, Southern Indies 12-2. They lead by four games over Springfield, who's 10-6. Then we are 8-6, so theoretically we're tied in the loss column for second in the East for now, as we have all these games to make up that we lost to COVID earlier. Drury's 14-2. They have a six-game lead over Rockhurst and Southwest Baptist, who are both 8-8. It's not really a division race at all over there, as Motz finishes 21-13, Lewis. Come front. Katie Kirkhart is in the game, 5'9", 5th-year senior. They've got a ton of those from Oklahoma. They'll knock a pass out of the way on the baseline. We talk about that almost every game, how every team seems to be so senior-dominated. Flyers are sophomore-dominated. This group going to be together for a while because they each basically have another year to tack on as well, so they can all be, you know, 5th-year seniors if they want. And basically, sophomores eligibility-wise for now. Right side for three, long, but they'll get an offensive rebound, track it down, and start over as Henderson picked that up. And a little floater from six in the paint, good! Eventually, Peyton Richards puts it home. The Flyer lead is six with the ball with a minute to go in the first period. Taylor Galuza, high right. She'll go all the way baseline. Gets it back outside, but it's knocked away and stolen. They'll run the floor, a two-on-two, and they get some help from behind. And Robinson will miss an NBA three from the right side. And the Flyers, the long rebound, run the floor to Motz. She'll drive right by Richardson and lay it up and in. Right by Robinson, I should say. And the basket good for the Flyers, who lead by eight again. Go left side. And a little bump foul, I believe, on Taylor Galuza trying to get around a pick. Now they've got Peyton Richards and Paige Robinson. I'm struggling with a little bit early here. Hopefully I'll figure it out. It'll be baseline left for Peyton Richards. They've already played about 12 players in this first quarter. Inside, it's Paige. And Steph jumped out again to get around the pick. And they're gonna call Steph Hart for that, her second. So boy, that's tough to have our best defender pick up two fouls in the first quarter. 22 seconds to go in the period. Flyers up 23-15. Have it up top, Moore with it. Kirkhart. Paige down the right side, banks it up, and in. Paige Robinson. So we're back up six, 6 seconds, five. Kat right side, step back three. No good at the buzzer. After one quarter, though, awfully good start for Lewis. 23-17, Flyers up, back in a minute on the Flyers Sports Network. Flyers one of two. Drury off to an 0-4-5 start from beyond the arc, so you know that's not going to last, but in the meantime, Flyers need to make hay while they can. Both teams four turnovers apiece here at the end of one. So Robinson has eight right now for Drury, eight of their 17. On the Flyers side, nine for Grace Hilber, five apiece for Schmidt and Motz, and then four for Courier. Now, why we have a delay here, the officials are looking at the videotape during the break because the officials called a foul as the buzzer sounded. So I'm not exactly sure what they're looking for here. there was an intentional foul. As the buzzer sounded after the missed shot. Not sure what else they could have possibly been talking about here. They're still trying to sort things out. Flyers up six for now. But those two fouls against Steph are going to be huge here. So she's going to start this period on the bench. With Courier, Schmidt, Taylor Galuza, Motz, and Hilber on the floor for Lewis. Well, they're going to say Katie Kirkhart will shoot two for Drury. So apparently the foul was on the Flyers there as the buzzer sounded. And I didn't see it from up here. They have not said who it was against. Well, something happened with 3/10. So whatever that was, it happened with 3/10. So the Flyers are going to inbound it with 0.3 to go. Now the buzzer sounds, and now we're going to start the second quarter. Well, that was just really weird. We're just going to play on. We're not going to now sit for another minute. But that, still not exactly sure. That's the only problem. Being up here on the balcony, you know, for the last 2 years because of COVID, we're not courtside. We're just away from people because I'm not wearing a mask. So there's no one anywhere near me. But that means if I'm not at the scorer's table, it's hard for me to pick up explanations like that on different plays. Well, regardless, the Flyers now up four with the ball, 23-19. Start the second quarter with Motz high right. Looking for somewhere to go. Had a ball knocked away from her. She picked it back up, takes a couple dribbles, and hits a 10-footer. Well, eventually found some room herself and hit the basket. And the Flyers back up six again. So Robinson has it up top. They go free throw line. Henderson on a little weave, get it up to Moore, who takes a 17-foot jumper, misses that, and Flyers rebound on Kat Schmidt. Front court, Taylor Galuza. Taylor down the right side of the lane, goes all the way. Had the shot blocked, it'll go out of bounds. Flyers will keep it. They say clean block for Moore. And Flyers will have it right baseline. So 6-point lead for Lewis for now. We're early in the second. We'll talk women's volleyball at the half, by the way. Cap. It's our tournament. Our team went to the tournament once again this year. It was ranked in the top 20. Motz, a little fade away from 12, no. Followed her own shot, no. Courier follows and puts it in. Well, they stuck with it. A couple of offensive rebounds, and the Flyers by eight at 27-19. Go outside with it. With a free throw line. Bounce pass down low. Kick it to Robinson for a right corner three and hit it. Well, you knew she would find the range eventually. Gets her first three of the night. And Donitz had gone down to the ground. And I think that's why they're allowing the stoppage of play, not calling a timeout. They're going to allow a substitution for her, plus another sub as well. Flyers against the press. Bring it in. Now, they were saying that Hilber was falling out of bounds when she caught the inbounds against the press. Well, she whipped it back to Kat, who had just inbounded it. But the official saying she had not officially established herself back in bounds when she caught it. So it's actually a turnover. They'll get the ball inbounds. Miss a little layup there from Finley, and the Flyers get it anyway. Taylor Galuza will clear out for her, and she'll come front. Taylor, outside Hilber. Hilber ran into her own teammate and traveled. Boy, oh boy. Taylor got in her way. And that's a tough unforced error. And it'll be Drury basketball. A little ragged there for a sec. Flyers still by five for now. 8:20 to go here on the half. The free throw line. Can't shoot it, so back up top. Launch a three, top of the key, missed that, and that's going to be over the top foul on Drury on Finley. He had position, they went over the top, and Flyers will get it out of bounds. And so Finley out, and Isaiah Lynch back in. It's the pressure, they'll knock the pass out of bounds, we'll try again. So they definitely made some alterations because we had a couple of easy layups off of the press early. And now we're having trouble even getting the ball in bounds. And we do get it into Grace. So now it's time for the Flyers to make alterations. Curry, skip pass right side to Schmidt. She'll take a wing three. Hit it, Kat Schmidt. Banks the tray. So Flyers up now, 30-22. Run their weave. And back Robinson at the point. Now it's Galuza on her with Hart on the bench with her two fouls. They go left baseline. Missed the layup. Good defense from behind by Courier. Then the rebound comes to Lewis as well. Motz, middle of the break. Beats everybody down floor. Kicks it left side. Wide open three. Hilber. Ooh, rattles it in and out. And Drury will pull down that rebound. 7:20 for the half. Drury down eight for now. Run that weave. Knocked away from behind, but it was knocked to a teammate of Drury, but then through her hands. So we forced the turnover after all. It was knocked away towards Terry and Moore, but right through her fingertips, through her legs and out of bounds. And Flyers end up with it anyway. Hart will come back in, and she'll be the inbounds player against the press here. Get it in. Eventually here now for the Flyers. That's Ryan O'Garrick in the game for Lewis. The 5'10 junior from Providence. Get it to Mott's left side layup. Good. Did a nice job at the high post to get around Henderson. Got a step on her, then beat her down the left side of the lane for the layup. 10-point Flyer lead and timeout Drury. 6:49 for the half. 10-point Flyer lead. Let's come back in a minute on the Flyers Sports Network. A long, long way to go, but Flyers up 32-22. One of the reasons why the Flyers beat 18th-ranked Umsl 2 days ago was defense. Allowed them just 60 points, beat them 70-60. It was Silver with actually four steals. I think I credited her with five earlier, but she had four to go with her 17 points. Schmidt had 20, and the Flyers hit 9 of 18 from three. It really made them work for every one of their baskets. Bob over the top, off the inbound. We block it from behind, but they're going to call the foul on Motz. Two shots coming for Isaiah Lynch. Which had Schmidt with 20, Galuza with 17, Hilber with 17. Motz had 9 off the bench. Another key to that game was rebounding. Taylor Galuza from the guard spot had 7 rebounds. Free throw missed there. And then Hilber from the other guard spot, 7 rebound. So from your two starting guards, you had 14 boards. Free throw good there. So 1 out of 2. Obviously, if they're going to knock off fourth in the country, those same kind of things will have to happen tonight. And so far, so good. 9-point lead after the 1 out of 2 from the line. Flyers in the front. Motz at the point. Looks for somewhere to go and finally gets it. Taylor Galuza. Right side, Cat for three, high right of the arc. Missed that one long, but Hart's there for the rebound. Takes a dribble, looks for help, gets it outside to Motz. Motz drives, spins, lays it up, no good. Rebound, Drury there on the run. They've got a 3-on-1 if they hurry. Bounce pass right side, chop it up and in. Good fast break bucket. Lynch finishes it off. Flyers in a hurry after they break the press. 6 minutes for the half, 32-25. Lewis, Hart. Two Drury players collide. One goes to the ground. Taylor Galuza wide open there for. Hits the three left side. So two pink jerseys collide. And that cost him. Now, thankfully, everybody's okay. But for the second, the Flyers had the power play, so to speak, and took advantage. They lob it over the top. Lynch under the basket. We double team. Misses the shot because of it. Flyers battle for the rebound and jump ball between Lynch and Motz. So Flyers by 10, 35-25 after that trade. Flyers 3 of 6 from 3. Drury just 1 out of 7 right now. Substitutions for both teams. Mots will come out. Courier back in. And now Terragaluza back in as her sister will sit. Drury left baseline for the inbounds. And I'm running out. They'll just fling it up top and get it in just to beat the clock there to Peyton Richards. Page with it high left. Page Robinson. And we're going to get a little reach in from Grace Hilbert at the free throw line. No shot involved. 5-17 for the half. And again, this team has scored triple digits in their last game. Right now they have 25. With about 5 minutes to go in the half. So the Flyers doing a nice job. Just early on. Have right side. It's past baseline. Skip pass high left. Had an open three, didn't take it. Instead they go back up top. That was Anna Hitt in the game for them. 5'10 freshman from Ozark, Missouri. Page will just launch a 16-footer. Hits the back of the iron, no. Rebound comes down to Kat, and she'll win the battle for it and get the rebound. Flyers in the front, and Hilbert. Hilbert left side, drives, goes all the way, banks it up. Yes, and a foul. Chance for a three-point play. Hilbert knocked to the ground, but she was able to finish. And she'll dust herself off and go to the stripe. 4:46 to go in the period. Flyers up 37-25. Chance to add another point to that as well. Well, and Matt and I had talked about it earlier in the year, how this team was almost too nice. They missed the free throw, but Kat, offensive rebound. Back underneath Courier, off the glass and in. How about that? Turned a missed free throw into a basket thanks to the offensive board. And the lead is 14, 39-25, 4:30 to go in the half. And then when they suffered that very tough one-point loss at home to make it their third one-point loss of the season, when they lost to Springfield by one, and there's a reach and foul and a hole down low. Oh, it's going to be on Stafford third. Oh, that's a killer. She's going to come out. She says, I don't know what I did. She's going to come sit down. Well, that's huge to take her out of the game. Again. Drury gets it inbounds. They launch a long two. Missed that. And rebound Drury to keep it alive. Go back under the basket, but then we steal a triple team. Lynch and Courier stole it away. Boy, team defense. We lob it to Courier. Wide open layup. Good. They tried to front her. We were able to spin away from that, get the feed, and get the layup. They'll win the race down the floor, but miss another layup by Lynch. What offensive rebound Drury. Page launches a long NBA three, misses that. And jump ball on the rebound attempt. Kat involved with more. So Robinson having a tough time hitting here early on. You know she's going to find the range eventually. But her long range jumping has not done the trick yet. But I think that third one-point loss really made them mad, toughened them up. And it's been a different team since then. Hey, it's been a healthy team and a team that has meant business, and their play has showed it lately. Well, knocked out of bounds. Drury will have it. Side court right. 41-25 lose. 3:39 to go in the half. Robinson to bring it in. Does so. Thomas. Free throw line to Lynch. Back up top, Robinson. We almost stole it. Page will crank the three. Missed that one. Rebound all the way out of bounds. No, Page tried to save it. She did, but saved it to Taylor Galuza. Flyers in the front. Inside Schmidt. Back outside Galuza. Wide open for three, so she'll take it. Missed it. Kat the rebound. She'll drive, lay it up, and in. Second chance points. And the Flyers up now 43-25. As we approach 3 minutes to go in the half. Well, not a ton of fans here, as you can imagine, because of the weather, but the ones that are here, awfully excited. Now they're gonna call that on the offense. And Flyers will get the ball back. Timeout once again for Drury. 30-second timeout with 2:59 to play in the half. 43-25. So 43-25 Flyers. We'll keep it here. I think it's going to stay a 30-second timeout. That's why we'll keep it here. Flyers still at 64% from the field at 18 of 28. Drury 10 of 30, 33%. They are 1 of 9 from 3, while the Flyers are 3 out of 7. Rebounds, Lewis leads that 16-13. Turnovers are 7 apiece. But second chance points, Flyers have 6 of those to 2 for Drury. Individually, Robinson, 1 of 6 from 3-point land. But she does have 11 points to lead them, and no one else on her team has more than 3. So she's been about the only offense. They're going to need some help. They're going to come back in this game while the Flyers have 11 from Hilber, 10 for Courier, 10 for Schmidt, 9 for Mons, and 3 for Taylor Galuza. Inbounded to Kat. Left corner. It's Tara Galuza. Underneath Courier. They double team. Lily gets out of there with it. Oh, and then at the last second, it was stripped away from her. And the ball was loose once more. Hilber almost was able to get that, but eventually Drury into the front court. Flyers by 18, 2:38 for the half. Top to Moore, 15-foot jumper good. Now again, Flyers had that kind of a lead down at Drury. We played before. Break the press. Courier in the front. But they were able to wear us down with only 8 healthy players in the gym. This one, I think, will be a little bit tougher to come back against the Flyers tonight, although that pass to Courier through her hands and out of bounds. She was actually looking for where to pass it to before she really had it. She took her eyes off it, and it skidded off her fingertips and out of bounds to Drury. As good as Drury is, this one might be a little tougher to rally. We'll see what happens as they high right side to Moore. Moore goes now all the way down low left. A little spinner. Floats that one up from 8 and drops it in. Nice bucket there. 43-29. Flyers the lead and the ball. 1:45 for the half. We'll talk to Laura Lee at halftime. A little women's volleyball. Domitz does take the ball away from Motz. She'll drive right. And Motz fouls from behind. Couldn't help herself. Domitz stopped. And Motz could not stop and bumped her from behind. Shot was no good, and 2 shots coming. From the 5th-year senior from Preston, Missouri. By way of Pittsburgh State. They have a bunch of transfers. Moore came by way of Illinois State. Domitz from Pittsburgh State. Kirkhart from Oral Roberts. Caitlin Baird for them actually started at Jewel. Now there for Drury. Of course, a whole bunch of JUCOs as well. Free throw, good there. Back within 13. That would be huge for them if they can get it back within single digits before the break. Free throw, good. So now the Flyer lead a dozen. Against the press, get it in. Taylor Galuza had it knock off her knee and out of bounds. Actually last touched by Moore, so Flyers keep it. And yeah, they have really tightened the clamps on this press. Get it in, Hilber. Hilber into the front. It's at the point. Looks for help. Break into the basket. Taylor puts up the shot. No, good defense to alter the shot there. Rebound comes down to Drury. Come down. Robinson turns. Misses a little 6-footer. Tipped out of bounds to Lewis. We're doing a nice job of clogging the lane and making those shots tough to get. 72 seconds for the half. Again, they put the press on. Try to wear us down. The time to get it in to Taylor, and she'll bring it front. Drive right side. Hand it off Hilbert. Race. Takes a 17-foot jumper and hits that. Nicely done. Had Kirkhart on her. decided it was going to be tough to drive around her, so just pulled up and hit the jumper over it. 45-31, 49 seconds to go in the half. More tough shot. Drew, contact. Now a chance for a three-point play for Terry and Moore. Well, again, they're not going to go away. They are number four in the country for a reason. Just how close can they get before the halftime locker room? 46 seconds to play in the half. And a free throw, good there. So 45-34, the lead is 11. Largest lead was 18, it's now 11. On the right side, Tara Galuza had the pass go over her head from Kat. Well, much more aggressive defense for Drury, causing some Flyer turnovers here. The Flyers have 11 first half turnovers, and that's definitely keeping Drury in this thing. 28 seconds, basically 1 second difference, game clock and shot clock. So they'll take a last shot if they can and try to get it single digits going into the locker room. 45-34 for now, 14 seconds. Dominic in the center circle, 8 seconds, drives right. Baseline pass intended for Robinson. We knock it away. She gets it back. Throws up the shot. No. Tara the rebound. And that's the buzzer. So Flyers go into the halftime locker room leading 45-34 against number four in the nation. We'll come back and talk about it and talk women's volleyball back in 2 minutes on the Flyers Sports Network. As far as the individual numbers in the first half, for the Flyers, three people already in double digits. Again, Grace Hilber, a really nice start for her, 13 points. She is one of two from beyond the arc. 10 points for Lily Courier. How about Kat Schmidt's first 10? 10 points, 6 rebounds. So a really good beginning for Kat. And then Amelia Montz with 9. But after that, you go to 3 for Taylor Galuza. And that's it, only 5 players in total in the scoring sheet for Lewis Yu. So they are going to need a little bit of help. The story here is Steph Hart, you know, our best one-on-one defender, has 3 personal fouls, only played 10 minutes, has not scored a point. For Drury, it's 11 for Paige Robinson, just 1 of 6 from beyond the arc, 5 of 14 overall, but still her only player in double digits. Then it's 7 for Moore, who has 4 rebounds too, so she had a really nice first half of play. 5 for Domitz. After that, 3 for Lynch, and a whole bunch of 2s. Findlay, Clevenger, Richards, Kirkhart, all with 2 points apiece. So Flyers up 11 as we start the second half of play. And turnover is a big key here. If the Flyers are going to win this game and hold off number 4 in the nation, they're going to have stop. They're going to have to stop turning the ball over. They have 11 turnovers already. 7 for Drury. Rebounds. Flyers doing a nice job there. Lead that stat 18-14. So here we go. Back in the Flyers. Knock off a top 20 team for the second game in a row. Drury will start the half with possession. We go left to right in front of me again. They're in the pink. Flyers in the black, and here we go. Down at tip top. Goes to the free throw line. Another little weave to Moore. And there's going to be a foul off the ball. And that's the second on Galuza now, so that also could be a key here. And they'll inbound under the basket. Get it up top, the free throw line. Out it back underneath. Findlay gets the bucket there. Nice job by Kent to get a hand on it. It went in anyway. They'll keep the press on, but now they'll sort of have a full-court man-to-man. Will clear out, and Taylor basically brings it up herself. Put it up top, Curry. A back cut to Kat, and lays it up and in. Nicely done. A backdoor cut. Got the feed. A little diagonal drive in the basket. And Domitz now on the right side. Dribbled it off her foot. Was able to track it down and save it. Feed underneath to Findlay. Stolen away by Courier. As that pass had a little too much on it. So Flyers by 11 in the ball. moves it right side. Back up top, Hilber. Left side, Schmidt. Back up top, high right side. Galuza. Impatient, but now it's 10 on the shot clock. Hilber right side. Galuza with 8. Dribbles to the free throw line. Finds Steph Hart for 3, high left of the arc. Halfway in, came out. Rebound comes down to Kat, and then with a double team, she couldn't put the ball back up. No putback attempt because of the good defense by Drury. Tried to find a teammate, knocked away from her, and now Drury in the front court, but a travel by Domitz, and Lewis gets it right back anyway. So good rebound by Kat, but she couldn't shoot it, and actually nice job to not force one. Then she lost the handle in the double team. Steph Hart with those 3 fouls, starts the period on the floor, drives right side, goes under the basket. Good feed to Kat for the layup. Oh, good play by Steph Hart to draw a double team. Kat by herself got the feed in the basket. 13-point Flyer lead. 8-11 for the third. Page in the front court. And she's 1 3-point basket away from all-time school lead in that category. She has struggled from distance so far today. She just has 1 in 7 attempts. Missing the paint there. As Finley could not connect, Flyers in the front. Inside Galuza in the corner. Left side, Hilbert. Right top of the key. Driving left. Looks for help. Back up Steph Hart. Shot clock to 10 again. Galuza. Way up top with it, right side. Dribbles it down to 5. Driving, stops. Little floater from 12, no good. Rebound Finley. They run the floor in a hurry. Robinson left side, going all the way hard to the basket. Banks it up too strong. Courier got in the way nicely. Rebound knocked around. Oh, but it'll be saved by Finley. Back out Robinson. Page with drives with a double team. And banks it up, no. But a foul on the Flyers. So 49-36 Lewis, 7-11 for the third. Robinson at the line. They never really said where the foul was at. Free throw, good. Oh, they're going to call it on Kat. That'll be her second. That one good. So she hit them both. 7-11 for the third against the press. Get it into Courier. So 49-38. Lewis U for now. Taylor into the front. And Flyers still at 62%, but they get another turnover as Domit stole the pass away. Lead to Robinson, who lays it up and in. That's the press. Flyers lob it all the way down, but that's a bad pass. Almost lost the handle. Courier picked it up and put it in anyway. But Moore almost stole it. Flyers end up with it anyway, and Flyers will call time. Full break. 6:46 to go in the third. 51-40. Flyers hanging in there by 11. Back in a minute on the Flyers Sports Network. So 51-40. Flyers out in front. And again, the interesting thing is, they get a long way to go. But Drury has the top scoring offense in the league at 80.5 points per game. So basically 81 if you want to round it up. 81 points per game for Drury. Lewis is fourth, though, at 70. So two high scoring teams. But for the moment, Drury's been held down. Go back outside. Domitz for 3, misses that. Long rebound comes down. Steph Hart for Lewis U. Drury, second best defensive team in the league. They only allow 62 a game. That's the difference here, where the Flyers already have 51. There's 6:19 to go in the third. Ball knocked out of bounds. Flyers have it. They'll bring it inside court left. Lewis allowing 69 a game on the average, which is good for 12th in the league. So Drury's scoring margin, the number one, they win every game by 18.5 a game. Oh, we get a great inbounds play. Get a good feed from Schmidt to Courier for an easy layup. 13-point lead. McDonald's. Back outside Robinson. Doesn't take the three. She'll drive instead. And she's going to, I was going to say, walk through a double team. Instead, they're going to call a foul. I'm going to call it on Taylor Galuza. So now you've got Hart and Galuza with three each. Hart's going to come out. She did not pick up her fourth while she was out there, and Motz will come back in. 6:04 for the third, 53-40, Lewis. Right side, Robinson. In the paint, turns, spins, leans, throws it up off the glass too hard. Rebound back tapped to the Flyers and Motz. Doesn't have numbers. Will drive anyway. Throw up the shot. No, but a foul, and she'll shoot two. It was a 1-on-4. She probably should have held on to that thing. Well, that you're going to call an offensive foul. Well, and I think that that's probably the right call. And that's what Matt is saying. Look, you didn't have numbers. Don't force the action. You should have waited for your teammates. I mean, it's easy to second guess and all those kinds of things, but it is an offensive foul, and Drury gets it the other way. They go high right side. Have it down low, and it's kicked away by Grace Hilber, so they'll try again. Drury, second best in field goal percentage at 45.5% on the season. Only Indy is better. They'll launch a three right corner, hit that. Well, Domitz was able to hit that. You really weren't going to keep missing. But they're only at 38% from the field right now. They have the deficit back to 10 anyway, and 53-43 after that. They're just 2 of 11 from three, though, for now. Flyers 3 of 8. Flyers still 64% from the floor overall for the game. Get it over to Taylor Galuza. 7 in the shot clock, though. Really good half-court defense right now for Drury. Down to 3, 2, 1. Kat will beat the buzzer, but missed the shot, and it did not hit rim. So turnover to Drury. Well, they earned it with that half-court possession. That was really good. And now we get a media break. 4:59 for the third. Flyers still up 10, though. 53-43. Back in a minute on the Flyers Sports Network. 4:59 for the third. One other item on the stat sheet. Regarding three-point shots, because Drury has the best three-point defense in the league. They normally allow only 29% from beyond the arc for their opposition. They launch a three, miss that offensively. Flyers rebound tipped off of Hilbert. Drury keeps it. And only Indy shoots better from three, so they're second best offensively in threes and number one defensively in threes. Tonight, and it's not been how it's been so far. Page gets the inbounds and gets an easy layup. Good set play there. So Robinson scores again for them. Flyers by 8 and the ball. Things getting a little interesting now. And they're going to call a foul on Drury. A little too aggressive on that four-court press. Get a bump foul. And we'll bring it in near half court. But again, 4 now. Flyers 38% from 3 while Drury only hitting 17%. From three, so flipping those numbers around at least for now. Hart back on the floor for Lewis. Getting in a cat in the front court. Schmidt with it. Couple of dribbles. Picks up her dribble and finds Courier right side. Right corner Galuza. Back up Schmidt. They're going to double her, so back outside Galuza. Hilbert pull up from 17. In and out. Rebound comes down Robinson. She'll bring it herself into the front. Steph ran away from her at one point to make sure she didn't pick up the foul as she crossed the timeline. 17-foot jump shot there won't go, but they get an offensive rebound off a Flyer deflection. So they'll keep possession. That missed shot, but an offensive rebound there. So two misses in a row by Richards. But now they get a Domitz three that doesn't go. Richards gets that rebound, and Domitz ends up with it again. And a bump foul, guess who, on Steph Harder, fourth. Oh, boy. And that's just where she got bumped into. So she'll have to come out. And Ryan O'Garrick will come in for her. Boy, that's a really tough one. just driving around her, bumped her shoulder, and she has to come out. But boy, Drury has cranked the effort up to 10 here in this offensive possession. And that is our fifth foul of the period with 3:35 to go in the quarter, so they'll be shooting the rest of the way, and Domit's at the line. They get some points here. They will have earned it. First free throw good. With a number of chances they have earned here. This is a game again. Free throw good. So she made them both, and it's just a six-point lead, 53-47. Flyers get it in against the press and clear out. They lose it on the front. Drives left side. And off O'Gara. Looks for help. Finds Kat at the free throw line, and Moore is going to foul her before Kat could drive to the basket. It'll be their third team foul with 3:21 to go in the third. Flyers up 53-47. 17 for Robinson. We get it in and get fouled right away on a double team against Schmidt as she got the ball in the inbound. That becomes their fourth team foul. So 17 for Robinson. Domit's with 10 now. Taylor gets it in right side. Hilber's open for three. Missed it. Rebound comes down to Moore. They're on the run. Go right side with it. Launch a right wing three. Make it! So they've had some misses, but they get a make there from Richards. And then they get a steal on a double team on the full court press. A three will tie it. They will miss that tray, though, and the Flyers get the rebound. Boy, Clevenger could have knotted it up. As it is, an 18-point Flyer lead in the first half. It's now trimmed down to 53-50 with 2:45 to go in the third. Free throw line, Courier. Offside. Drive, Hilbert all the way. No, but a foul, and two shots coming for the Flyers. 14 for Courier, 14 for Schmidt, 13 for Hilbert. Schmidt with 8 rebounds. The sophomore having an outstanding day so far. Kirkhart is out, and Finley back in for Drew. 4 personal fouls for Hart. Free throw good. 4 personal fouls for Mott's. That's why that offensive foul was so tough. So those two have 4, and Galuza has 3. So that's another key to this game, is that free throw good. On their side, only one player has 3, and that's Finley. No one else has more than 2. So only one team in foul trouble. That's the team right now with a 5-point lead after the free throws of 55-50. 2:22 to go in the third. They go free throw line. Lob it down low to Moore. Moore turns around, takes an 8-footer, misses it. Rebound battle for, knocked out of bounds. It'll be Flyer ball. Last touched by Clevenger. Then they'll keep the press on. Having trouble getting it in. Get it to Courier, finally. Now she'll bring it front court. Looking for help. She's dribbling left wing. Picked up her dribble. Gets it to Schmidt, free throw line. Knocked away, but eventually Galuza ends up with it. Wide open left wing. Courier for three. Got it. Big, big three for Lily Courier. The lead was trimmed to 3. Now it's back up to 8. 58-50. 1:45 to go in the third. They run their weave, drive right side, bank it up, too strong, rebound battle for, Flyers come out of there, and Hilbert, she's on the run. One player to beat, puts it up off the glass, around and out, rebound battle for, it goes out of bounds, and a heap of bodies, it'll stay Flyer ball. Coach Egan, not too happy that it's Flyer ball. It was tough to see from her bench that far away, but frankly, it was tough for me to see, and I'm looking right down at that play. Yep, official saying it hit off of number 40. That's Finley. Hit off of her leg, he said. Lob it up top, Courier. She takes a dribble, looks for help, and finds the loser. Boy, the half-court defense by Drury has just been incredible of late. Shot clock to 8. Galuza for 3. No good. Long rebound. And they'll track it down. Drury will come back now. Down 8. as you approach a minute to go in the third. Bounce pass baseline to Moore, lays it up and in. They have made every pass a tough one for the Flyers. Get it in, Galuza against this pressure. They'll clear out for her against Diamonds. 58-52, Lewis the lead in the ball. 50 seconds for the third. The Flyers have spread it out. All five players were above the free throw line there for a second. As again, they try to get it baseline to O'Garrick, and Moore challenged that pass and knocked it out of bounds. They have been everywhere. Flyers bring it in, 13 on the clock. Get into the Courier, and a six-footer good. Well, lobbed it to the tallest player on the floor who caught it, threw it up and in. 8-point Flyer lead. Domitz drives, banks it up and in. She just drove left side, nobody stopped her. Flyers by six and the ball. They'll probably take the last shot of the half, last shot of the third. 15 seconds on the clock. Way high right side. Hilber. 9 seconds. She'll drive right. Down to 4 seconds. Whips it over left wing. Galuza takes a 16-foot jumper. Good at the buzzer. Got the open shot and hit it. After three, Flyers lead fourth-ranked Drury 62-54. Back in a minute on the Flyers Sports Network. Flyers to inbound it. Get it in. Hilber to start the period. 62-54. It is for now. Courier left side. Gets it Hilber. Grace left side. Picks up her dribble, looks for help. Moore all over. Playing really good defense. Finally get it up to Schmidt. Shot clock to 10 now. Schmidt top of the key. Back over to Hilber with 7. Grace. 17-footer blocked. Boy, they collapsed on her so aggressively. Robinson into the front. Kick it outside. They launch a long tray. Miss it. Rebound O'Garrick. So the miss there by Richards. Flyers by 8 in the ball. O'Garrick gets it. On that weave. Find Kat down low right. Drives. Blocked by Moore. They say clean block. And Moore takes it away. Moore. Underneath, Richards banks it up and in. Paige Robinson, I'm sorry. Again, I knew Richards and Robinson. I don't know why. Messed them up a couple times. 62-56. Flyers the lead in the ball. 8:40 to play. Garrett right corner. Ball knocked away, almost stolen. Hilber with it, free throw line. Back outside. Galuza, 9 on the shot clock. She'll drive, go all the way, lay it up. Yes, and a foul! Chance for a 3-point play. Well, that time Moore tried for the block and didn't get it, but she does pick up the whistle. So chance for the 3-point play here. Hart will come back in, O'Garrick will come out. And she's going to see how long she can play without fouling out. I don't think she's going to come out unless she does foul out at this point. So Robinson, 19 points. She's only hit 1 3 tonight. Free throw, no good. Rebounds, Kat Schmidt. So they could not convert on the 3-point play, but they get an offensive board, and maybe they can make it a 4-point play. Right side, Galuza. Right left side, Courier. Left corner, wide open, Hart for 3. Got it, Steph Hart, they make it a 5-point play thanks to the offensive rebound on the free throw miss. Now they're back up 11. 67-56, 8:05 remains. Get it underneath. Page spins, puts up the shot. No, if they call that a foul on Steph Hart, that's a crime. Oh, that's absolutely criminal. Absolutely criminal. That was a touch at the absolute most. An absolute crime. And she comes out of the ball game. That's a terrible call. Robinson at the stripe. Horrible. Free throw is good. Well, the officials have taken Steph Hart out of the basketball game. We'll see if the Flyers can survive without it with 7:52 to go and a lead of 67-59. Nice pass to Schmidt. Handed off Curry. He'll lose a right side. Lobs it to Kant. Good feed to Courier. Moore, again, with incredibly quick feet, catches up to Courier and knocks it out of bounds. She has been the MVP tonight, especially on the defensive end. She has been incredible. If they win the game, she's going to be the reason why on the defensive end. Lob it up top, Courier. How was that not a foul? It was way more a touch than Steph had. Drive the right side, no. And they're going to say shot clock violation as it missed everything. And we'll come back the other way with Drury. Unbelievable. And I have said very little. I think literally one other time in one other game have I talked about any calls. But come on. 67-59, Flyers by 8. Drury with it, 7:15 to go. Moore, left side, little floater from 8, around and in. 6-point lead in the ball, 7:07 to go. Flyers into the front. Hilber, left side. Now Courier. I will say that this has been the best officiated season in my 19 years that I've been here for the Flyers. But that one is unbelievable. Terragaluza gets it up top. Taylor with 7 on the shot clock. She'll drive, turn, spin, and they're going to call a hold down low, I think, on Moore. No. Going to call that on Clevenger. 22 for Robinson, 12 for Domitz, 11 for Moore. 19 for Curry. The ball knocked out of bounds. To lead the Flyers now. How about the fact that Courier is 9 of 9 from the field? Hilber with 15 points, Schmidt with 14 points and 9 boards. We get it in to Galuza. Right side, Hilber, 10 on the shot clock again. She'll penetrate, look for help, turn, spin, 12-footer in the lane, good! Tough bucket for Hilber. Back up 8 with 6:22 to go at 69-61. And a great job defensively by the Flyers. Taylor Galuza knocked it off the knee of Domitz out of bounds. They're going to give it to Drury. Ay, ay, ay. Three officials, nobody saw it, that it went off of her knee. Unbelievable. Lob it up top to Moore. Run their weave. Robinson from 16. Good. Well, she struggled from beyond the arc, but not from inside the arc here tonight. The lead is 6 again with 6 minutes to play. Flyers still 60% from the floor overall. 41% for Drury. Flyers 5 of 12 from 3. 3 of 16 from 3 for the Panthers. Galuza, right corner. Hilber, step back 3. No, rebound battle for Drury has it. And it's a 6-point game. And Robinson in the front. Except her dribble, lobs it down low, and they're going to call a hold on Lewis before any shot down low. Well, Motz with her 4 fouls will give Courier a breather. Up top, Richards. Now Robinson. Robinson picks up her dribble, looks for help. Fade away from 10, rattles in for Findlay. 4-point game. Now tipped out of bounds on the full court press. Flyers to try again. 5:19 to go. Flyers up, but it's 69-65 now. Press is on again. Motz with it. Dribbled it off foot, but what, Hilber was there to pick it up. And Hilber in the front. Finds Schmidt. Back Hilber. Back Schmidt. 8-footer, no good. Rebound battle 4, and Drury has it. Page into the front court. Drives around Hilber. Lays it up and in. 2-point game. 69-67. And a foul on Drury on the inbound. And immediate timeout. 4:48 for the ball game. What a finish this will be. 69-67, Flyers by 2. back in a minute on the Flyers Network. Well, again, Drury number four in the nation for a reason. Flyers won the first quarter 23-19. They won the second quarter 22-15. Third quarter won by Drury 20-17. And right now they lead this period 13-7. For now, Flyers lead the game now 69-67. Flyers have the ball against the press with 4:44 to go. And Hilbert comes into the front. The second half defense of Drury has been the best defense I've seen by any team all year. No question about it. Will it be enough to get them all the way back? Right side, Hilbert. Pull up from 17, right side short. Rebound comes down to Moore. They have a chance to tie or take a lead. They have not tied it or led all day. Robinson for three, left wing, no good. Rebound, Kat Schmidt. Still just 1-3 tonight for Robinson. A bump foul on the left sideline by Domitz against Galuza. That's their fourth foul, so Lewis will be shooting the rest of the way. Lewis only has two team fouls in this period with 4:10 to play in the contest. Lewis up 69-67. Yeah, I've mentioned some calls and things, but again, if Drury comes all the way back, they will have earned it. This defense has been spectacular. Kat, they collapse on her in the paint, so back up top. Hilber for three. Yes, Hilber, friendly roll with a big, big three-pointer. 72-67. Fast break after the made basket. They launch a three of their own, missed that. Rebound tip to Schmidt. So Flyers now by five and the ball with 3:40 to play. So a little breathing room for the moment. No one has played better half-court defense against the Flyers this year than this team in this half. The ball knocked away from Taylor Galuza. She went to the ground to pick it up, and the Flyers call time from the bench. So 30-second timeout for the Flyers. We'll keep it here. And Flyers beat the 18th-ranked team in the nation, Umsl, 2 days ago. Have led wire to wire so far against number four Drury, but not over yet with 3:31 remaining. 26 for Robinson today, but again, just one of seven from three. 12 for Domitz. She's also played really well defensively. 11 for Moore with seven rebounds, two steals, two blocks, and she's been brilliant on the defensive end. Lewis, 20 for Hilbert, 19 for Courier, 14 for Schmidt with 11 rebounds. So Kat with a double-double. And 7 for Taylor Galuzzi. Two steal day. By the way, Courier, the 19 points, 9 of 9 from the floor, and 3 steals. Inbound to Motz, goes all the way, lays it up and in. All of a sudden, back up 7, 74-67. With 3:20 to go. Domitz up top. Run a little weave, Robinson. The free throw line. A backdoor cut, Robinson runs into Motz, and a blocking foul. They're gonna say she was in the cylinder. Two shots coming for Robinson as that thing was halfway in and came out. 3:07 to go. Motz has fouled out now, so we've had two players foul out. With 3:07 to go. And I'm talking to the official about something before we replace Motz, because you've got the 60 seconds to do so. She tried to draw the charge, could not, so Courier was getting a breather, has to come back in. Tara Galuza is also in. So both Galuzas on the floor. With Hilbert, Courier, and Schmidt. Free throw good. 5-point game if she makes this one. And she does not. Well, a rare miss. 3:05 to play. Flyers by 6 and the ball, and it's Hilbert. Talk to Matt after the game. Now, usually the video feed, if you're watching that, it cuts out almost immediately at the buzzer. So we go to WJOL.com for the audio of the postgame show. if you're outside WJOL radio range. We get it to Courier in the right block. She is fouled before any shot. But again, bonus the rest of the way. She'll shoot two. And then the same holds, because we'll stay on for the pregame show of the men. The video won't pick up until right before tip-off of that. So you can hear our post-game interview with Matt and then a pregame interview with Coach Trost on the website, WJOL.com, between games, before the video picks up again on the conference website. First free throw, good. And that one good as well. So Courier has just been outstanding tonight and basically perfect. 76-68 Lewis. 2:42 to go. Drury has it in the front. High left side. Now Robinson way up top. McDonald's on the right side. She'll go all the way baseline. Bank it up and in. She has had a brilliant game. 6-point lead for the Flyers in the ball. 2:22 to go. Hilber with Donitz all over. On the right side, Galuza. Get that ball to Taylor Galuza. Moore tried to steal it, knocked it out of bounds. Flyers will keep it. 2:08 to go. Flyers by six for now at 76-70. So Schmidt will get it and bring it in near half court here on the near side. As we look down on things, get it in, Taylor Galuza. Taylor driving right, goes all the way for a right side layup, good! Nobody stopped the player with the ball. Back to an 8-point lead, under 2 minutes to play. Robinson back outside. Now Finley drives right, turn, spins, can't shoot it. Back outside again. Underneath, Finley behind the basket, throws it to the corner where Hilbert tried to steal it, tried to save it. It went out of bounds, as she did as well. But it'll stay Drury ball with 14 on the shot clock, 1:41 for the game clock. Don't get me wrong, the half-court defense for the Flyers has been pretty doggone good as well. They keep this lead for the moment at 78-70. Domitz, she's fouled. Will they give her continuation because she made the basket? They're going to give her continuation and a chance for a three-point play. So 1:36 remains, 78-72. Chance to make it a five-point game. And good. And Flyers trying to finish this off without two of their best players who have fouled out. And a five-point lead for now, 90 seconds to go. Break the press, and it's Hilbert. Up top, Schmidt. Looking for Taylor. Can't find her and call timeout. She was going to get a five count. Good smart play by Kat Schmidt there. She had no one to pass it to because, again, their aggressive half-court defense had everybody covered. 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. Again, we're back Saturday for a conference doubleheader. Southwest Baptist is here. 1 o'clock start for the women, 12:45 our pregame. And then McKendree is here Monday, conference doubleheader. Women's tip-off 5:30, our pregame at 5:15. Then they go to Maryville on the 24th, S&T 26th. Women may host the conference first-round game on the 28th. But let's see how that goes. For the moment, we're fifth in the points. Drury number two in the points, behind Upson. Flyers trying to win their sixth in a row. They had an 18-point lead in the first half. It is down to a 5-point lead here, 78-73, with 1:17 to play. It's never been tied. Flyers have never trailed. Get it in, Galuza. Tied on the shot clock after that timeout. And Taylor drives, and Moore going to get a bump foul from the side. And that's a ticky-tack foul, too. So, I mean, I call it a ticky-tack against Steph. I will call it a ticky-tack against that one. They just sort of bumped hips. I don't think that was much of a foul either. Free throw.
throw, no good for Taylor.
You need all these the rest of the way, that's for sure, if you're going to hold off this team. 1:11 to go. And good there, one out of two for Taylor. And the lead is 6-79-73. Robinson to the front. Go high left side, Richards. And Robinson. Back over to Domitz. A drive right against Hilbert. Back up Richards for a right wing three. We blocked the shot. Cat picked it out of the air. Flyers get it. 6-point lead and the ball. 50 seconds to go. Get it across front court and get it left side. They were going to take a three, but realize let's run a little clock and then get fouled is what happened. As Moore had to foul Hilbert with 43 seconds to go. But Moore, with that foul, fouls out with 43 seconds to go. So Clevenger back in. But she really had no choice. Couldn't let any more clock run. And Hilbert at the strike. 20 for Hilbert. Missed that one. Making it interesting. 21 for Courier, 20 for Hilbert. And a 14-12 game for Schmidt. Free throw good there. So one out of two. 80-73, Flyers by seven with 43 seconds remaining. And the shame of that one for Moore was the bump foul before, you know, the one that she had to take to put the Flyers at the line. Again, we'll keep it here. Because again, it wasn't much of a foul either. But no question that her fifth foul she had to make. For Drury, Robinson, 27 points, 11 of 23 shooting, just 1 of 7 from 3. Richards, just 1 of 5 from 3. That is one of the big stories of this game, obviously. 3-point shooting. Flyers, 6 of 14. Drury, just 3 of 18. Flyers winning rebounds, 32-27. Turnovers, the Flyers do have 19 to Drury's 11. Overall shooting, Flyers still at 59% to Drury's 44%. Drury with the ball, throw it in towards the basket. Now they kick it out for a Page three-pointer that's no good, and a rebound foul on Drury. Flyers will shoot two with 37 seconds to go, and an 80-73 lead, but some pressure on the freshman now. And Tara Galuza, and she will go to the stripe. 80-73, 37.2 remaining. First one is good. That one was perfect. Sister taps her on the back and says, nice job. And got that one. Two perfect free throws for Tara. And she's in it in crunch time with two players fouling out. And it's now 82-73, Flyers by nine with 37.2 and a timeout called by Drury. It's a full timeout. Let's take the full break. Let's come back in 1 minute. 37 seconds remain. Drury inbounds it, and they're going to call Galuza for a foul. Wow, that's her fourth. And that puts them at the line without any time going off the clock. You absolutely did not want that foul either. Wow. So Robinson at the stripe. That's huge for them. To get a couple of points here with no time elapsing. Yow. One more coming for Paige here. I mean, you want to deny her the inbounds, but enough contact was made, I guess, for the whistle. One more shot coming for Robinson. Got it. All of a sudden, things a little more interesting now. 36 seconds to go. And a reach-in foul on Drury on the full court press to stop things, and the free throw shooting contest continues. So 82-75. Flyers the lead with 33.8 now. So not a lot of time elapsed there. So now it's up to Hilbert to hit her free throws. First one is missed. And Hilbert's the one who went at the line, 81% on the year. Got that one. One out of two. 83-75 is the lead. 30 seconds to play. Richards can't shoot the three, so she'll drive and get the two-point layup instead. 83-77 to get it in. And a quick foul. Anna Hilber again will go to the line with 23.7 to go. And their whole thing is, if we just keep hitting one out of two, they come down for quick twos or threes, there's enough possessions left to maybe inch back into this thing. Because it's only 83-77 right now. Flyers definitely need both of these from Grace Hilber. Made that 84-77. And 85, so got that one to go as well. Back to an 8-point lead. 23 seconds to go. In front. Page will crank the three. Missed another. Rebound battle, four bodies to the ground, and they came out of there with it. They're going to get a 2-point basket. And now there's a whistle. As Domitz put the ball in, it was Richards who was slow to get up after the collision. And they're going to say she's okay, so it's no timeout. But actually, they're going to bring her out and bring in Anna Hitt into the game, a freshman, with 14 seconds to go. Flyers by six against the press. Get it into Courier, and she's fouled in a hurry by Robinson. And now it's Courier at the line. So Courier today, 21 points, 9 of 9 from the floor, 1 of 1 from three-point land, 2 of 2 from the stripe. So she hasn't missed anything yet today. With 13.3 to go and her team up 6, what will she do here? The throw is good. She stays perfect. 86-79. And 87, she stays perfect on the day. Wow, 8-point lead, 13 seconds to go. They need a three in a hurry. Domitz, kick it left corner, hit for three, missed it, rebound, battle four, it rolls out of bounds. Flyers are gonna win, there's only 2 seconds to play. How about this? Flyers are going to beat number 18, Umsel, and number 4, Drury, in the span of 2 days. Look to get it in bounds, do so to Taylor, and that's that. 87-79, your final. The Flyers, with two of their top six on the bench fouling out, survive a wild and wacky one here today. They led wire to wire, had an 18-point lead that was down to 2 here in the fourth quarter. But hey, hang on and win it. We'll come back in 2 minutes, total it up, and talk to the coach back after this 2-minute break on the Flyers Sports Network.